Welcome back for round two of Briefing 2.0. Why don't we start right in with the questions. In Washington, D.C.
Michael Ford, Washington, D.C. How can the U.S. help prevent human rights violations in the Congo?
That's a good question. The first thing is to try to stop the fighting. Among the various groups that are in the Congo, you have rebel forces that are there, and this is a real mixture of ethnic differences between the Hutus and the Tutsis that go back a long way and that have erupted in some terrible ways in the past couple decades, most recently in the during the genocide in Rwanda. You have political differences among various states there, whether that's the DROC, Democratic Republic of the Congo, and Rwanda and Uganda. So there's a real volatile mix there with a proven track record of perhaps producing very violent behaviors and real human tragedies. So, a lot of times these things come down to security, trying to get the security question right. And the African Union has been very active in trying to mediate among the various groups here. Former President Obasanjo of Nigeria recently had a mission into the DROC to try to get the various forces to separate, to create a space where humanitarian aid can be delivered in a safe space for the citizens and displaced people to reside. So that's the first step, and hopefully we can build on those particular efforts. But it's going to take a while. There are over a million people that have been displaced in that Great Lakes region over the past several years. So try to stop the fighting, deliver humanitarian aid, and then also manage the politics and come to some political resolution. If that formula sounds kind of eerily similar to a lot of other conflicts around the world, it's just because those are the basic elements of trying to resolve these things.